Morning Central.
It seems we've had a bit of a switcheroo with the newscast.
Oh, well, it seems like we have. Anyways, me and Joe are here to bring you all the information you need as a student of Central Crossing.
Information like what the wonderful weather has for you.
Sure. Yeah, take it away, Ben.
Good morning, Central Crossing. I'm Ben, and I have your weather news. Now, if you didn't notice, it's a little frigid, so I hope you are all wearing your coats and not just a little windbreaker, but a big, puffy winter jacket. Well, the high is going to be 24 degrees and the low is 14 degrees, and unfortunately, there will be no abundant sunshine. So sad. But the air quality is good, so you can go outside and deeply inhale. But make sure you are bundled up because it's still cold outside. And on a special note, the moon is in a waxing gibbous phase. I have no idea what that means because I tested out of that section in 7th grade science. So obviously, I am completely 100% qualified to say that it is the best gibbous. And on a final note, it's Justin Timberlake's birthday, so I'm going to jam out to some Man in the Mirror. That's all I have for you today. Back to you, anchors.
Thanks, Benny boy.
That weather sure sounds like winter for sure.
You know what would go amazing with this winter weather?
A large mug of hot chocolate?
Absolutely. Let's head over with Kylie with this more information.
Hello, Comets, and happy Tuesday morning. I'm Kylie, and today's National Day is National Hot Chocolate Day. I really wish I made some hot chocolate this morning because it's really tasty, but also because it was really chilly outside. Around the 19th century, hot chocolate was used for medicinal purposes and was sold on the shelves in London pharmacies. However, we know hot chocolate to have ancestral backgrounds from the Aztecs, Olmecs, and Mayans. Now, in modern-day society, hot chocolate is not used medicinally and is associated with being consumed as a treat on a chilly day. But let me ask one question to create some much-needed chaos. Do you put whipped cream on your hot chocolate? Now, as you're arguing with your friends about hot chocolate, it's my time to turn the camera back to Anna and Joe. I hope you have a wonderful day, Central, and back to you, anchors.
Thanks, Kylie. That sounds super delightful.
Do you put whipped cream on your hot chocolate, Joe?
Definitely. I love whipped cream. Do you?
Oh, absolutely. Not to brag, but I have the best homemade whipped cream on the block.
Bring me some, and then I'll believe it.
Maybe I will. Now, let's talk about things happening around here.
First, let's take a look at our clubs.
Going on. Come out and get involved. In addition to clubs, we have some Valentine's Day coming your way. It's the Key Club Carnation Sale. It starts tomorrow and continues through next Thursday. For just $1.50, you can buy a carnation during lunch periods that will be delivered second period on Valentine's Day. So, there are three colors you can buy. Red for your love, pink for your secret crush, and white for a friend. Quantities are limited, so buy before they sell out.
Next up, we have Michelle and Jordan with our sports news for today.
Good morning, Comets. Jordan, we were finally put back together on air.
I know, and I'm so happy that our duo is back.
Well, I want to highlight our spring sports, which are in preseason conditioning. It is not too late for you to join in. Have fun, make new friends, and get in shape. Check out the Cafe TVs for more info.
I have an update on one preseason sport, softball. These Lady Comets are lifting every Tuesday and Thursday from 6:30 to 7:30 a.m. The first day of tryouts is February 20th. If you are trying out, you must have a physical on file. If you have any questions, see Coach D in room 162.
Now, we have some result news.
The Central Crossing Girls Gymnastics team competed at Olentangy Merlin last night. Competitors included Olivia Cox, Aaliyah Horn, Kelsey Thompson, Ariana Weber, Sophie Knapper, Mackenzie Cox, and Mason Thompson. Take a look at these ladies in action.
Thank you.
is all of our district teams. Of course, the lady comments are the best. Good job, gymnastics.
Now here's what's going on tonight.
Girls JV and varsity basketball is going away against Hamilton Township High School. The first game is at 5:30 and the second game is at 7.
Boys JV wrestling is going away against New Albany High School at 5:30.
Now, here's what's going on tomorrow.
At home, we have our All-Stars against Franklin Heights at 6:30.
Well, that's all we have for you guys today.
I hope you all have a terrific Tuesday.
Back to you, anchors.
Thanks, Jordan and Michelle.
Good luck, girls basketball and JV wrestling.
And with that, please rise for the pledge. The pledge stands for so many things in our country and shows another way to support all those who fought for us. Here's Kyle to lead us.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Kyle. And thank you to all who participated. Well, that's unfortunately all we have for you today.
Fortunately, we'll be back tomorrow with some more impeccable news.
Be sure to enjoy your winter weather with steaming cup of hot chocolate.
Maybe you all could try to make some homemade whipped cream today.
I would totally try that. Sounds great.
You know what else sounds great? Get into first period. Bye, Central.
Bye.